Hey everybody, welcome back to another practice with me and the Stratocaster. Yeah, we're gonna get into it. We'll do a couple of exercises that we have done, more that we haven't done, and just keep rocking. Let's start with some of this warm-up stuff. We'll actually try a different warm-up. Let's go with descending. Thank you. we go. We'll try 114, go us swinging first. Not doing it well enough to justify what I'm trying to do, so we're just gonna ease off. That was good warm-up. Good warm-up. Oh man. Alright. Let us dial it back. And I really like that exercise we've been doing with the six heads. Thank you. scratchy noise off my nails. It's really bugging me. Oh, that's not my nail. It's my pick. Back to a focus practice. But what I can do is keep this beat going, and we'll do the next phase of it.
Mm-hmm.
Up to 90, let's go! Love it. Let's go a little faster. See how we do at 100. Good kind of fast, and hopefully I can just keep increasing, getting better. Let's keep going. Just kind of shake it out, holding all that tension, especially in that right shoulder. Can I pop it? A little bit. Oh, that felt good. Okay. All right, let's give it a go.
Sure.
Let's give it a shot. We did it.
Oh, kind of.
106. I think we're going to stop at 106. And let me crouch down. Ooh, both my knees. Let's go to Pyromania. We're going to come back to this a little bit because I got a little
frustrated with stage fright because my down picking really isn't what it needs to be to play that song.
And we're gonna come back to it, but I have to figure out this whole down picking thing because a lot of songs I want to play, a lot of music I want to play incorporates that down picking or even like the galloping picking, or I call it galloping picking. I don't know what other people call it, like little bursts, speed bursts. I gotta find a solution to it, but for now, we're gonna move on to Too Late for Love. We'll give it a listen first. Forgot how good this song was.
Too late. Interesting. All right, now that we got a feel for it, man, such a good song. Don't you love that song? Let's go. I already have Lick Library pulled up. Hold on. Not as well pulled up as I would like, but let's go here. Too Late for Love.
So the intro for Too Late for Love goes a bit like this. So we're starting out with a low open E string. Then we're sliding into the third fret with the second finger on the A. Then we're grabbing the second fret on the D. So. Then from here, we're going to slide from 3 to 5 on the A. Then grab the fourth fret on the D. So you should have. At this point, we move on to a variation. So we're sliding into the fifth fret again from the third fret on the A string, then grabbing 5 on the D, and going back to the 5 on the A, and grabbing 4 on the D. So. And we finish the riff with. So it's like the first one again, sliding into the third fret on the A, grabbing the second fret D, and then we're going to play the second fret A and the low open E. So that's the intro riff. Let's just recap that from the top. Section continues on with a very similar chord progression, but now with a bit more
distortion. Hold on.
We have this riff.
Hold on. Not gonna rush it. Gotta get that.
So this uses all the same shapes as before, but without sliding around. We're going to have open low E, then we're going to play 3 and 2, A and B, then move our same shapes up 2 frets, and then we're going to have 5 on the A and the D, then back to 5 and 4, then back to 3 and 2, and then 2 low open E's. Top. A minute detail to look out for there is once we've gone to the 5 and 4, before to get into that double 5 power chord there, we're going to do a quick hammer on. So you're going to hammer on the third finger onto that D string on the fifth fret. Back and finish off Okay. Let's hear that one more time. Watch out for that hammer on. And the chorus riff is pretty much exactly the same as the first riff. It's just a bit more aggressive. We have this. So as you can see, it's all the same chord shapes as we've picked out from intro and verse, except we're playing slightly differently. So we're playing each of those chords twice. Now later in the song, there's a quick transition at the end of the chorus, which takes us into another riff, which is just this. Which is two open A's, and then the fifth fret and the D and the G. So now we're going to take a look at the bridge section. This is kind of like a game vocals, doing lots of woes, and...
doing lots of woes! Doing all the woes! Alright, let's give that a little shot. Little shot. I covered that part with him. I don't know that part.
go back to the Slick Library Sandbell video.
Oh,
this
is
teaching it now.
So this riff consists of two parts. We have this kind of rhythm on the A string. We're going to be putting it into the little double note chords in between. So the first one is this. Then we have 10 and 9 here G. And then from this point onwards, we have two openings between each chord. So the next chord is 9 and 7. Then we take that same shape, and the next one will be 7 and 5. And then we're going to move that down to 3 and 2. So we have. And then it looks a bit different here. We have. So we have 3 and 4 in G. And then we have 3 and 5. And then we have 5 and 5. So those are the main elements. Put the A string riff in there.
I wasn't paying attention, I'm sorry, Sam.
And G. And then it gets a bit different here. We have. So we.
Hold on.
We have 3 and 4 D and G, and then we have 3 and 5, and then we have 5 and 5. So those are the main elements. So we have. And then it gets a bit different here. We have. So we have 3 and 4 D and G, and then we have 3 and 5, and then we have 5 and 5. So those are the main elements. Okay, put the A string riff in there.
Cool! Okay.
Thank you.
ball! Give me another, sir! Skip one. Try it again. Instead, take a second. Stop. Wait a minute. Trying to force it. Forcing it doesn't work. Doesn't work. It's never worked for me. Or has it? Right now it's not. Dumb. Ow. Go.
might actually be it for today. That was a lot of fun. It's the best when practice just clicks and you're having fun all of a sudden. Like, it's, you know, you know. If you don't know, get to know. That's how we do it. Oh, turn all that off. Thanks for coming, everybody. That was a blast today. That was probably the most fun in a practice I've had for a while. Could have been the song. It could have been the fact that, like, my picking is coming along. I don't know what clicked on that. I just gotta keep doing it, I guess. Well, not just doing it, but, like, kind of hitting these plateaus and figuring out my technique and making those little adjustments. And, it's gotta play better. Thanks, everybody. Have a good one.